Recording this meeting. Okay, we'll try to mix the meeting, yeah, with synchronous and asynchronous. Then this week we have asynchronous. Yeah, well, last week we have asynchronous. Now this week we have a chance to discuss, yeah, everything related with the last week and then with this week material. So currently we have 10 students, yeah. I will present twice, yeah, the beginning and also in the end, yeah. We have Mbak Astri, Mas Bayu, Mbak Devi, Mbak Dila, Mbak Yuda, Mbak Hana, Mas Ilmi, Mas Rizal, Mas Tommy, and Mas Yusuf, yeah. Okay. First we will have a review for last week material, yeah. Do you remember about the topic? Yeah, the topic is about sentence. Yeah, first preposition, then sentence and utterance. That's why we go speaker's meaning and yeah, sentence meaning or sentence meaning and speaker's meaning. Anyone here that want to share the summary of last week? What is preposition? What is sentence meaning? And what is the utterance meaning? Ya. Ada yang mau menyampaikan review sedikit? Belum, mungkin dari saya. Oh ya? Oke, okay, if not yet. Ya. Yeah. I will try to make kind of imagination, yeah, with a comic. Have you ever read comic before or watched in a television? Yeah. If you have those experiences, yeah, you will find a bubble, yeah, in a comic. Sebentar, saya akan coba carikan. I got the picture, but it has a low pixel, so sorry for this, yeah. Take it from passive and active voice materials, yeah. Passive and active voice, but this is not about passive and active, but we'll concern on what is preposition, not preposition, remember, yeah, preposition, what is sentence meaning, what is utterance meaning, yeah. As human, yeah, in semantic theory, we have thought. Kemarin yang kita lihat a triangle of meaning, ya, segitiga makna by Ocean and Richard. Nah, ini we can relate here. Yeah, that triangle of meaning we have thought what is inside of our mind. Yeah. Everything comes from our mind, right? But let's take one sample. Nah, ini pura-puranya aja. Imagine that a man, ya, yeah, have kind of thought in his mind related with an Instagram posting. Yeah, ini that a random thought, yeah. An Instagram posting that has a low likes, that is disliked by others, or not yet get respond by others. Nah, ini dalam pikirannya. It is in his thought, yeah. Masih belum terbentuk suatu susunan tata bahasa. That's proposition. Jadi ada sebuah maksud. There is aim for someone. Yeah, there is a thought of someone. That's proposition. A thought of something, yeah. For example, about that Instagram posting. Got it? Jadi there is a thought. Or in semantic. terminology, we have it as proposition. Nah, then it comes to a realization, it being realized. Realize and make a grammatical meaning ya, with, nah ini nggak harus tertulis ya, tetapi misalnya kita tuliskan in a sentence ya. Seperti ini, no one like my post. Aktif, kita lihat dua aja. Lalu yang kedua, my post was not liked by anyone. Ini contoh dua dulu. Those two samples are the concrete meaning, ya, the realization from the thought that the Instagram posting has what a low response from his friend, ya, is not interesting and extra, ya, it is thought, but it's realized in a sentence, in a grammatical meaning ya, no one like my post was not like by anyone. Itu tertulis dan mungkin masih di bayangan kita ya. Jadi satu proposition, one proposition can have more than one sentence, karena bisa dibuat contoh yang simple ya, can be made ya by an active voice or can be made by a passive voice. Aktifnya juga bisa macam-macam ya. Nggak harus no one like my post. Mungkin setelah ada thought seperti itu, ya, orang tersebut membuat susunan kata yang berbeda-beda. Misalnya ya. Ya, misalnya, there is a zero likes in my post. Nah, itu bisa. Ya. Itu kalimat yang bisa dibentuk, ya, in bahasa ya. Sentences that can be made from one thought. Jadi ada satu pemikiran itu bisa tercerminkan dalam 1, 2, 3 sampai beberapa kalimat, ya. Tapi itu belum diucap. Nah, itu namanya proposition. And then those who are arranged in a good order, ya, it's sentence meaning. Karena maknanya itu. Tetapi kalau diucap bisa maknanya lebih dari satu, ya, tidak hanya makna tunggal. It's not a singular meaning. For example, ya. Ya, oke. Okay. No one like my post, then you utter it. No one like my post with kind of regret. For example, why I post this one? Okay. Misalnya nanti Mas Yusuf bilang seperti itu dengan nada menyesal. Ya, no one like my post. Kita bicara yang aktif dulu. Lalu kemudian Mas Rizal bicara dengan nada yang bertanya-tanya. No one like my post. It want to know the full reason. Ya. Atau misalnya Mas Bayu has a bet, taruhan ya. Misalnya taruhan sama Mas ini. Ini just for imagination ya. The imagery explanation. Ya. Karena taruhan yang boleh. Mas Ili, let's bet that no one like my post. Okay. Then no one like my post uttered by Mas Bayu, but with the excitement. Ya, bisa aja. Itu namanya utterance. Jadi ada satu sentence yang belum diucapkan. Itu kalau diucapkan oleh berbagai macam orang, maksudnya beda-beda. That's what's the meaning of utterance meaning. Tuh. Makanya kemarin dalam tugas ya, because this is a theoretical class ya, I give kind of assignment questions that lead into your critical thinking ya. Mungkin beda dengan kelas skills atau kelas teaching ya, yang ya yeah, we can have the clear sample of tra ya. Here in semantic pragmatics we discuss about theoretical things ya, yeah, theory and theory. First, before we apply it in a conversational analysis. And that's why
if on the video explanation last week ya, yeah, we got Macbeth role play. Nah, ada yang ingat? Mbak Syada, Mbak Hilda, dan lain-lain ingat ya? Nah, in the assignment, I just change. Saya hanya mengubahnya dari Macbeth role play menjadi Romeo and Juliet, ya, script. Atau kita bisa menggantinya dengan misalnya ya, Mahabharata script. Atau misalnya yang sudah akem ya, misalnya scriptnya Harry Potter. Ya. Oke, paham di sini? Nah, kita membahas sentence meaning and utterance meaning. Nah, saya close dulu, stop sharing. Sentence meaning and utterance meaning. Nah, pertanyaannya kemarin kan, kalau menggunakan script asli, autentik, ya, apapun itu ya, autentik yang autentik itu diubah-ubah enggak? Diubah-ubah tidak? Do we change to the authentic? Kalau ini dibilang authentic, is change or not?
No.
Oh, thank you Mas Rizal ya. So, ya karena kelas teori, makanya kita bergumal dengan apa hal-hal seperti ini ya, critical thinking. Ya, kalau authentic itu tidak diubah. Ya, jadi misalnya saya buat ada script authentic yang terkenal ya, atau Harry Potter dimulai dengan Once Upon a Time. Nah, itu di semua script authentic kalau menggunakan yang berdasarkan hak karya cipta ya, with the copyright with that one ya, Once Upon a Time. Itu naratornya misalnya ya, the narrator will say Once Upon a Time in every beginning of role play. Jadi apakah authentic script di misalnya kita ganti Harry Potter itu memiliki sentence meaning yang sama? Jawabannya iya.
Yes.
Karena selalu oh, tertulis tidak. Seperti itu. Yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh yes.
Kan tertulis semua tadi Once Upon a Time, Once Upon a Time ya kan? Kalau authentic misalnya itu J.K. Rowling menulis Once Upon a Time. Lalu saya tanya tadi ya Mas Rizal ya. Mas Rizal jadi direktur role play drama ya. Once Upon a Time gitu. Itu enggak diubah. Itu sentence kalau tidak diubah itu artinya sentence-nya sama enggak?
Sama, Pak.
Sama. Script yang mau dipakai Mas Rizal dan teman-teman kelas ini misalnya mau wanna conduct a role play with that ya, authentic script, the answer is same sentence. Once upon a time, scriptnya yang ini once upon a time. Karena apa? Ini pengantar yang lain ya. Karena role play itu kan ada yang modified scriptnya kan. Tapi ketentuannya dalam assignment tadi atau dalam video kemarin adalah authentic. Nah, kalau modified, sutradara itu sudah memodifikasi itu berbeda cerita ya kan. Jadi nanti kalau modifikasi ya jelas belum tentu sama, jawabannya no. Tapi kalau authentic, yes, yang sentence meaning, ya, remember about sentence meaning. Nah, tapi kalau modified ya, once upon a time-nya mau di delete, mau diganti in a bright sunny morning, ya, Sunday morning, ya, there was, misalnya gitu boleh. Tapi kalau ini authentic ya, script-nya sama. Nah, sekarang ya, yeah, we move to the second discussion. Ya, yeah, whether it is on the video presentation or in the what is it? In the assignment. Kalau yang Harry Potter tadi, yang Mas Rizal jawab sama sentence meaning-nya. Sekarang kita bahas utterance meaning. Nah, Mas Rizal sudah mengadopsi yang sama plus teksnya, skripnya Harry Potter. Mau dibuat role play di kelas ini yang berisikan 14 mahasiswa. Utterance meaning-nya sama enggak dengan yang script apa? Utterance yang di script-script yang lain.
Difference.
Different. Thank you Mas Rizal. Ada lagi yang lain? Pendapat sama atau beda? Different or same if we talk about utterance meaning?
Different.
Different.
Nah, dari kelas misalnya ya, ayo latihan dulu. Rehearsal, misalnya rehearsal. Once upon time, coba saya yang pengen jadi narator, Mbak Hana. Coba Mbak Hana, once upon a time, gitu. Mbak Hana, atau tadi Mbak Hilda.
Yes, sir.
Please say once upon a time.
Once upon a time.
Nah, oke, okay. Mas Bayu.
Once upon a time.
Nah, lalu kemudian Mas Rizal sebagai sutradara mau milih siapa Mas Rizal yang mau jadi narator?
Milih saya aja, Pak.
Oh ya, karena sudah mendengar latihan di kamar mandi sendiri ya. Once upon a time. Bebas, ini hanya bercanda. Tapi kita dapat ilmunya, maksudnya Mbak Hilda tadi bilang apa, Mas Bayu bilang apa, Mas Rizal bilang apa, sama atau beda? Nadanya mungkin Mas Rizal di kamar mandi, mandi langsung dengan once upon a time, gitu kan? Itu sudah kata-kata yang berbeda. Lalu latihan lagi. Orang yang sama, the same person, in different second, mau ngomong lagi, itu sudah different utterance. Namanya sejak ucapan. Ya. Jadi nanti jawabannya adalah do the authentic script of-nya, many things ya, Macbeth, Romeo and Juliet, Harry Potter, and so on, has different utterances. Ya. Even if it is uttered by the same person, but in a different time, it's different utterance. Sama orangnya, tapi mengucapkannya beda detik saja sudah beda ucapan. Ya, ya ini kayak prinsip orang kembar pun berbeda genetiknya ya, walaupun hanya berapa persen, 0, setiap orang itu berbeda. Nah itu sama utterance. Misalnya nanti Mas Tommy di rumah mengucapkan latihan itu ya, once upon a time. Lalu satu menit kemudian bilang once upon a time, itu sudah berbeda utterance. Nah, tapi once upon a time yang tertulis di script itu one sentence ya, sama. Namanya sentence meaning, maknanya itu once upon a time. Pada suatu ketika. Nah, tapi dengan adanya utterance meaning, nanti kita bisa we can add ya the same meaning, additional meaning, and extra. Karena beda. Kayak kemarin itu, come here. Ya kan? Come here. Itu kalau kita baca tulisannya, ya belum diucapkan ya, itu ya come here. Semua sama. Come here, secara susunan. Itu come and here. That's the compound one. Ya. The phrase. Itu sentence meaning. Tetapi kalau sudah diucapkan dari Mbak Astri, Mas Bayu, Mbak Desmike, Mbak Devi, Mbak Dila, sekalian ngabsen ya ini, Mbak Erviana, Mbak Hilda, Mbak Hana, Mas Ilmi, Mas Rizal, Mbak Syahada, Mas Tommy, ya, Mbak Wafa, Mas Yusuf, Mbak Siti, ya, itu ngucapin berbarengan satu frase yang come here, udah punya 15 utterance yang berbeda. Nah, saya kira cukup reviewnya ya. Ada yang masih bingung? Proposition, sentence, dan an utterance. Itu yang sehari-hari kita, cuma dalam kelas namanya aja linguistik ya. Kita belajar teorinya, kita belajar terminologinya. Nah, itu kita bawa ke dalam teori, ke dalam sebuah pembahasan. Ya. If you have a question related with this, do you have?
No.
Okay, Mas Yusuf, thank you. Okay, so we'll continue ya to the current materials this week. After discussing about sentence, proposition, and utterance, ya, we are going to discuss about meaning, but it will focus on types of meaning. Jenis-jenis makna. Jadi besok dimensi setelah lanjut ya kita berkembang jenis-jenis makna dan lain-lainnya baru masuk ke pragmatics ya, makna dalam konteks. Now our current topics today is about types of meaning ya. But first after knowing about semiotic, semantic and pragmatics ya, symbol ya, sign and extra ya, and meaning in general, we'll discuss specifically about meaning ya. Jadi pertama itu semantik and fragmentik kemarin sudah, ini hanya untuk slide pengantar ya. Semantik itu lexical semantik ya. The meaning of sentence, we have propositional meaning, compositional meaning ya. That's why we have those. Nah, dulu ya semantik like mathematics ya has been studied for thousands of years by philosopher ya, the logicians and the linguists ya, for example Plato, Aristotle, that those experts are discussing about semantik. Ya. Kemarin ini closingnya pertemuan pertama kan? Ya, philosopher, logicians have tended to concentrate on restricted range of sentence. Ya, typically statement or propositions within a single language. Jadi kita kalau belajar filsafat dan lain-lainnya semakin mendalam ya, dari sebuah single statement saja dianalisis macam-macam. Pak, the approach are different ya. The linguistics approach is a broader in scope, so we have a broader ya limitation ya. We have broader in scope. What is the aim? The aim is to study the properties of meaning in a systematic and objective way with reference to as a wide range of patterns and languages as possible. Jadi nanti makanya kalau kita memahami makna itu bisa luas, tidak hanya berputar dengan single statement and then what is the thought, what is the the principle of the theory and extra. No, we can merge that into a broader scope. Ya. Makanya Eugene and Richard itu kemarin mengutamakan the meaning of meaning ya. So, dari symbols kemarin ya, and what is symbol? Social convention. Kemarin kalau kita melihat ya traffic light that has a green color, ya means to go and extra dan something like that. Nah, ada mungkin dalam kartun yang saya tampilkan di sini. Ya, ada pertanyaan, what is the meaning of life? Nah, ini ada joke ya. Karena it's reflected by our current condition right now ya. I don't know ya. The computers are down. Nah, ini nanti dalam pragmatics makna dalam konteks ya. This is not the literal answer ya. What is the meaning of life? Then the meaning of life is I don't know, the computers are down. It's different response ya. What does it mean? Kalau ada gambar dan percakapan seperti ini ya, dalam bubble is uttered ya. Maksudnya apa? I don't know, the computers are down. Mau menyampaikan apa ke kita? Ya. The drawer, the maker of this conversational animation, this comic, implies something. Ya. Imply that we are tend to look at the computers, look at the website, look at the Google. Do googling ya of something related with a word meaning. Ya. Jadi ada ditanya suatu kata, we have the search engine ya. We look at the search engine, then we look at the search engine. Sometimes we depend so much on a website, on a computer to know a meaning of something. Ya. Tapi itu salah satu proses ya. Gak apa-apa. Ini hanya sebuah ironi ya dalam masyarakat kita, dalam kehidupan kita di abad sekarang. So what is the meaning of life? Ya, then the philosopher we can say this is a saman or something like that ya, the smart people like in bahasa ya. Ya. That say that I don't know, the computers are gone. We depend so much on the then we change into another discussion ya. If we have a meaning of this kapitalis. Dan kita mencermati apa itu kapitalis, Ya, it can get reflected ya in certain pictures. The first pictures on my left. Ya, on your left. There is a picture. There is a someone on the sky. There is a city on the low border of that. There is buildings, animals, yeah, and extra. And then there is a hand that's pointing, yeah, point out the face of someone. The face of someone. Yeah? It's like the capitalist itself. What does it mean? Yeah, we can get a reflection to this. This meaning, yeah, we can have hidden meaning on it. Ya, yeah, it can has imagery. Dan ini ada makanya jenis-jenis makna. Ya. Dan kapitalis in the second picture, in the center, there is a human with a gold coin, but with a big hat. Ya, yeah, this kind of imagery things. Ya, yeah. And that's kapitalis. What does it mean? Yeah, you can interpret by yourself. Then the third picture with the money bags. We know bags. It can carry a lot of things, stuff here. But this is about money. Yeah, the shape is like human. This is kind of capitalist meaning. Yeah, from those three meanings, yeah, we can get what is capitalist. Itu namanya makna apa? Nanti kita bisa tahu setelah we take a look on types of meaning. Yeah, Cornea, ini pengantar dulu. Yeah. Apa itu? Nah, from those authentic samples, ya, yeah, because I took it from references, ya, yeah, one of an expert. Nanti teman-teman, ya, yeah, you can also browse another expert from different definition. Ada nanti pengembangannya juga ada, has the same what is that approach, but with the modification. But here in our classroom meetings, ya. Yeah, we'll have Geoffrey Lee, yeah, one of the expert that I want to share. Dan satu dulu, nanti you can elaborate from the other references, yeah, from other expert. Here, he was born in Gloucester in 1936, yeah. Yaitu pertama adalah stylistic of English poetry, lalu style in fiction, lalu berkembang ke semantic and pragmatic, yeah. Principle of pragmatics, yeah, itu remains a key text in the field and his new book. Jadi Geoffrey Lee itu teori-teorinya banyak diadopsi oleh expert-expert sekarang ya tentang semantic pragmatics. Lalu salah satu teori yang terkenal itu about a pragmatic of politeness ya. Just last week itu maksudnya ini tahun 10 tahun yang lalu ya, because I took the teori ya for my research too ya about politeness strategy. Jadi nanti politeness strategy ada macam-macam, salah satunya dari Geoffrey Leach ya. Selain tentang makna, jenis makna, juga tentang pengembangan politeness strategy. Then he is also the founders of the field of corpus linguistic. Corpus ya, nanti teman-teman mencari tahu what is corpus ya. Nah, itu Geoffrey Lee. Nah, maknanya itu ada dibilangnya itu kadang seven types of meaning ya. Tujuh jenis makna dari Lee. Satu itu conceptual meaning, itu kadang dibagi sendiri ya. Lalu berikutnya adalah associative meaning. Nah, associative meaning ini, the associative meaning are divided into the other six meaning ya, ini hanya penjabaran besarnya, itu masuk associative meaning, conceptual and associative meaning ya. Then the rest will be divided into connotative meaning, social meaning, affective meaning, reflected meaning, itu n-nya enggak ada ya, collocative meaning and thematic meaning. Nah, now let's figure out what is the each type of meaning by Geoffrey Lee. Ya, sebentar. Okay, we'll continue ya. Nah, conceptual meaning. Nah, ini gampang kalau teman-teman tahu dalam bahasa Indonesia juga ini disebut denotative meaning or cognitive meaning. Ya. Denotative meaning means ya about something of the content that is denoted to that thing. Ya, refers to logical, cognitive, or denotative content. Nah, concern with the relationship between a word and the thing it denotes. Nah, seperti yang saya sampaikan tadi. Ya. Jadi itu denotative meaning, conceptual meaning. Makna apa adanya ya, the literal meaning, cognitive meaning. Paham ya? Here, if we talk about hat, ya, yeah, this is our hat. The very denotative correlation between the word hat and then what refers to it. The thing it denotes. Hat. Tapi kalau kita sudah masuk ke hat, the other types of meaning, instead of conceptual meaning, ya, yeah, kadang kita ada headmaster, ya. This is the head of department. That's different. Okay. Bring additional concept. Nah, conceptual meaning ini adalah the essential and inextricable part of what language is. Karena ini dasarnya ya, dasar pengembangannya. Walaupun tadi headmaster itu tetap ada a new broad meaning, tetapi tetap ada dasarnya itu dari conceptual meaning. Head. Head is something that is very important in human body. It controls other part of the body. Nah, itu brings into another type of meaning. Ya, tetapi itu adalah dasarnya kenapa ini disebut essential and inextricable part of what language is. Nah, kadang dalam feature-nya semantik itu selain pakai the denotative meaning, kadang pembagiannya secara konsep bisa disebut seperti ini. Sebentar ya. Okay, sorry for the inconvenience ya. Biasa kalau online di rumah kadang ini ya, ada beberapa hal yang harus kita perhatikan. Okay. Oh, Mas Tommy ya. Oh, it's okay. Mas Tommy ya, I just read your chat ya. So, Mas Tommy responsibility later on will watch the recording ya. From this meeting. Okay. Okay, we'll continue. Nah, maybe if you ask in your assessment, nah, nanti ada ASN 1, ASN 2, ASN 3, kalau suruh diminta, kita diminta membuat semantic feature, itu kita kolokasinya adalah it's about conceptual meaning. Yeah. In conceptual meaning, yeah, we got a very yeah, structured definition. In every concept, we brought the other concept that filled, that built, that scaffold into this meaning. Ya, yeah, for example, man and woman. Dua dulu ya, yeah. Man and human, woman. We bring the other concept from human. Ya, yeah. We know another background knowledge human. Apa itu human? Nah. Lalu kita taruh di situ sebagai one of feature, feature-nya human-human. Nah, kalau man itu masuk dalam definisi human, dia akan plus. Woman plus. Ya, yeah. So both are human. Oke, okay. Yang membedakan nanti apa? Oh, adult, adult. Oke, okay, plus. Male, male. Nah, feature males akan berbeda. Di sini kita secara semantic feature akan membedakan what is man, what is woman. Ya. Yeah. Male in man plus, and then woman in a male in woman minus, because it doesn't fit with the definition. Nah, akan kenapa tiga feature? Karena akan membedakan dengan girl, boy, bull misalnya dengan tadi kalau bull misalnya nanti dengan human-nya juga beda kan. Bull apakah manusia? Bukan, binatang. Jadi human-nya minus. Adult, male dan sebagainya ya. Bull plus adult minus male minus. Karena bull is not adult yet. Ya, but it's already it's immature yet, ya. So that's the difference between girl and woman. Nanti apa bedanya boy dan man pada adultnya lagi dan lain-lain. Jadi feature we can think a definition about another concept that support this word man, woman, girl, boy, girl misalnya. Nanti kita akan ada misalnya pembedaan dengan misalnya hospital and police station. Nah, nanti kita buat feature-nya ya. It's about building, yes, plus plus. Nanti yang membedakan apa? For sick people. Nanti yang police station kan tidak. Atau untuk lainnya misalnya social services, yes, plus plus. Tapi yang membedakan apa? Misalnya tentang itu, satu untuk merawat orang sakit, satu tidak. Nanti bisa dibalik ya feature-nya, mau mencari yang khusus ke police station sendiri. Nanti ada pertanyaan, Pak, semantic feature-nya itu sudah ditentukan atau enggak? Ya, Kak, kita yang menentukan. We are as a linguist, ya, create a feature that suits with the word that we want to define. Karena asalnya man and woman, kita harus berpikir, oh, persamaannya apa? Oh, human. Okay, plus, plus. Then what is the differences? One is about gender. Ya, misalnya male and male. Atau ini bisa ditulis juga female, female boleh. Female-nya nanti dibalik. Yang woman, female-nya plus. Yang man, female-nya minus. Seperti itu ya. Ini pengantar ke types of meaning related with the cognitive meaning. Nah, nanti kalau ada cognitive meaning, penjabarannya selain definisi, kita bisa menjelaskan pakai semantic feature. Ya, with this kinds of explanation. Okay, then the next one, kita masuk ke associative meaning ya, yang ada 6. Yang pertama, from those associative meaning, we got connotative meaning. Nah, it's a bit easier ya. It's a little bit easier to study about meaning because in bahasa, because linguistic is universal, right? In bahasa Indonesia, we got this kind of definition too. Ada makna konotatif. Nah, that's why konotatif meaning is about, yeah, meaning that refers to over and above its purely conceptual content. Over or above or beyond, we can say like that. From its purely conceptual content. Kalau conceptual ya maknanya itu, pure itu. Lalu kalau konotatif ada di makna di baliknya, makna di atasnya, atau kita sebut atas, bawah, dalam boleh, ya. Maksudnya makna lanjutan, ya, dari itu, makna yang tidak sebenarnya. Nah, bedanya kalau itu sudah jelas teman-teman tadi ya. Kalau conceptual meaning and connotative meaning is the peripheral, ya, and it's relatively unstable. That is, it may vary according to culture, historical period, and the experience of the individual. Nah, budayanya beda. Mungkin sama-sama budayanya, masanya beda. Ya, the generation that have those kemarin ya, three steps of getting meaning ya, those interpretation are different. Ya, sama-sama masanya, sama-sama budayanya, tapi background experience-nya berbeda. Nah, ini konotatif meaning-nya kadang bisa terpengaruh ya. So that's why the difference between conceptual and connotative meaning ya is unstable. But it's open-ended in a sense which conceptual meaning is not. Jadi kalau konotatif meaning itu open-ended tadi kan, tapi kalau konotatif kalau conceptual meaning ya this is stable. Beda dengan connotative meaning that still open. Ya, depends on the background knowledge, depends on the culture, depends on the historical period. Tadi ya. The bell rings, ring gitu kan, jam 2. Kalau konsep plural meaning ya artinya it's time, the time is over, it's 2 o'clock. Kalau konotatif meaning ya the time is over tadi. Kalau conceptual meaningnya ya it's 2 p.m. 2 o'clock. Atau maksudnya the class is dismissed. Atau nanti di budaya yang lain, di background knowledge yang lain, jam 2 itu waktunya makan obat bisa juga. Ya, that's about konotatif meaning. Ya. Ada ini konotatif meaning tentang stepmother. Ya. We watched a movie, read a novel, fairy tales, a story ya, related with stepmother in Cinderella, in many kind of story ya. It's very cruel. Stepmother in conceptual meaning ya, ada ya. Bukan ibu kandungnya ya. It's not about biological mother ya. It's about another mother ya. Stepmother, the low mother, etc. Tapi characteristic that attached to this, we have another connotative meaning about stepmother. That is very cruel, yeah. Bad, easily to mad, and extra. Yeah. But that's about connotative meaning. In, yeah, in the context of movie, in the context of fairy tales, Cinderella fairy tales, and another basic fairy tales that portrayed a stepmother. Yeah, that make a framing of stepmother. Tapi the reality, ya ini kan step, ya can be a different one, ya. Connotative meaning from a BBC news misalnya, from a stepmother. There are many good of stepmother. Nah inilah makna lebih, makna lanjutan dari cognitive meaning berkaitan dengan stepmother. Jadi tergantung apa tadi? Culture, depends on the period of time, depends on the background of knowledge, background of experience, and etc. Nah, itu tentang connotative meaning. Now, we have social meaning. Nah, what a piece of language conveys about social circumstances. Nah, ini penambahannya. Sama-sama semua itu mirip. Yang asosiatif kan ada conceptual, lalu asosiatif. Asosiatif dibagi 6. Nah, kenapa ada mirip-mirip? Tapi pembedanya di sini yang akan ditekankan. Pembedanya kalau ini itu conveys about the social circumstances. Jadi ini nanti ada faktor-faktor sosial yang mempengaruhi ya, dialect, ya, time, province, status, modality, singularity, ya, modality, language of, ya, modality is about the setting, ya, language of memoranda, lecturer, jokes, it's different later on, brings another social meaning. Singularity itu misalnya the style of Dickens. Tiap ya, we talk about literature ya. In every writer have different singularity, different style. Ya, Dickens, then we got another famous from, for example, Andrea Hirata. We can get another like what that? Tadi ya, J.K. Rowling. Many of writer have the singularity. Ya. Nah, contohnya nih. Kadang ada kata ini, demisil, tapi kaitan dengan sosial itu apa? Oh, very formal, official. Nanti dalam word choice, sebagai guru, sebagai mungkin nanti as a language learner, as a language, apa? You work on the language field, and extra, you can choose it. Ya, residence, abode, home. Nah, ini maknanya kalau konseptualnya nanti sama tentang sebuah building ya, rumah. Tapi kita bisa menerapkannya based on the social meaning. Kalau domisil itu terkesan formal atau official. Kalau residence ya formal, not very formal but formal. Sometimes we see at the adverts that talk about residence ya. Then abode. Mungkin kita temukan dalam komiknya apa? Atau novelnya ini tentang abode. Apa itu abode? Cari di kamus. Oh, ini rumah. Nah, itu kak kesannya secara sosial adalah about poetic. Nah, kalau umumnya ya home. seperti itu. Nah, misalnya tentang kuda. Nah, dalam sebuah novel ini disebut steed. What is it? Oh, is it horse, general? Atau kalau dalam slang, it's snack. Misalnya, for baby language, this is GG. Misalnya seperti itu. Ya, yeah, that's social meaning. Nah, dalam social meaning, ada selain tadi Geoffrey Leach, itu Martin Jos itu mengembangkan social meaning yang disebut the five clocks. Ya. The five clocks itu hanya istilah ya, bukunya itu the five clocks. Skripsinya Mas Kevin itu meneliti ini ya, kakak angkatan teman-teman, kampus 2, Martin Jos Kevin. Kevin mahasiswa kita ya, Martin Jos expertnya. Maksudnya the five clocks by Martin Jos itu ada jenis-jenisnya, social meaning-nya itu frozen, formal, consultative, casual, and intimate ya, singkat saja. Ini hanya contoh bawah itu gambar imagery saja ya. Maksudnya itu frozen ya. Frozen. Apa itu frozen? It's not just about a movie ya, frozen movie, but it brings a definition. Nah, it we can carry the meaning from the title of the register itself ya, frozen five language register ya. Kadang di public voice kita ada tiga, frozen, formal, consultative. Dari kelima itu tiga muncul dalam public voice. Nah, apa itu frozen? Frozen itu ya, atau disebut static register ya, kata-kata komunikasinya itu sangat jarang berubah ya, hampir 100% itu ya, bisa berubah sangat sedikit persentasenya. Namanya itu frozen in time and content. Ya, contohnya misalnya pledge of allegiance, word to a song, poetry, prayer, ya, preamble to the US or Indonesian constitution, the alma mater, itu bahasa-bahasa frozen. Contohnya besok kalau teman-teman yudisium ada itu namanya Panca Prasetya Alumni. Nah, itu frozen register from our daily life ya, from our konteks ya, or proklamasi, or many things ya, UUD 45 itu frozen register. Atau kalau di doa-doa tertentu ada doa yang frozen ya, yang bukan doa the individual ya ini, but this is frozen language. That's about type of frozen register from Martin Jos ya. Then formal, setelah frozen we have formal. This language is used in formal setting and one way in nature. Jadi kayak kita ya, kalau dalam a format in a formal setting ya, misalnya speech, presentation, academic paper, essay, sermon, ya, announcement, interview, itu sample of formal register. Ya. Then we have consultative registers after frozen, formal, then in the middle we have consultative register. What is it? Yeah, this is a standard of communication. Two way. Tadi kalau tadi one way, this is two way communication used in conversation. Yeah, but no past experience with that person. It's professional discourse. Bedanya nanti di sini dengan yang setelahnya. Yeah. This is two ways, but this is it doesn't bring to previous experience from those interlocutors, ya. Yeah? It's professional discourse. Contohnya ya, konsultatif itu yang tengah-tengahnya antara formal sama nanti casual ya. Kayak strangers who interact, misalnya di ATM, di antrian, di tempat makan, ya. Yeah? Adults at work, teacher with students, talking with a lawyer. Nah, teacher with students kan nanti itu konsultatif ya, bukan one way seperti speech, presentation tadi yang formal ya, tapi sudah masuk ke konsultatif. Counselor and client gitu. Nah, kemudian setelah itu ada casual register ya. This is informal. Setelah tadi konsultatif, we have casual register. This is informal language used by peers and friends. Nah, sudah beda lebih dari membeku tadi, frozen sampai sekarang sudah sangat mencair ya. past experience with that person. So we have background experience. We know each other well. Slang, vulgarities, and colloquialisms are normal because those interlocutors know each other well, has a history, has a personal experience before. Yeah, this is group language, yeah. One must be member to engage in this register. Tergantung nanti casual registernya, close friend, ya, among a group language. Contoh dari casual register. Talking with friends, ya, personal letter to friends, talk with teammates, chat, emails, personal blog. If Instagram can be different, ya, but if we have kind of personal chatting in Instagram, we can have that as casual register, ya. Talking with our family, ya. Kecuali kalau ya, we have an awkward family, ya. Sometimes with a father that rarely met once in a year, ya. Maybe our language are different, ya. That's a different context. But usually we have casual register in our family, ya. The last one, intimate register. Ini yang lebih, ya, yang paling cair. This communication is private, ya. Language shared between couples, twins, ya, very close friend, not just about group of friends, but very close friend. Language of sexual harassment, nah ini contoh, ya. Oh, this is taboo, sir. No, this is just sample in academic discussion, ya. Why we have this one. Then next, it is reserved for close family member, for intimate people. Jadi ada yang keluarga yang sangat intimate, itu beda nanti dengan yang tadi yang masih ke casual atau malah yang sebelumnya, ya, mungkin jarang bertemu, ada anggah ungguh politeness level that is different, ya. Finish each other sentences, misalnya sampai segitunya, ya, sampai kadang kalau misalnya lihat konten TikTok itu, kalau teman-teman sekarang ada yang apa, ada kata-kata apa, itu pasti kembarannya atau teman dekatnya tahu kelanjutannya apa. Nah, itu sampai segitunya itu sudah intimate register. Ya, spouses, boyfriend and girlfriend, siblings, parents and children, ya, very good friends, that's examples of intimate register. Nah, itu social meaning tadi, ya, sudah dikembangkan. Sekarang kita kembali ke atasnya lagi, ya. The fourth is about affective meaning. Ya, affective meaning. Ya. Then, ya, affective meaning. It's about reflecting the personal feelings of the speaker, including his attitude to the listener or his attitude to something he is talking about. Ya. Key-nya adalah affective. Kalau dalam education, in education we know what is affective. Ya. Affective is about emotion, emotive. So it's reflect the personal feeling. Nah, sama-sama asosiatif, kalau yang afektif ini ada imbu-imbuannya feeling, ya, ada tambahannya feeling. Will you belt out for a child? Ya. Ada kata-kata home, misalnya dalam sebuah percakapan ada home, itu nanti kesannya secara feeling kepada pelaut atau tentara yang lama nggak pulang, itu nanti masuk ke affective meaning, ya, because they are far from home, they rarely met the family, for example, like that. Then mother for a motherless child, gitu, ya, mungkin bilang ke ibu ayah kata-kata itu ke anak-anak yatim piatu nanti akan berbeda. Nah, that's about affective or emotive meaning. Ya, yeah, I hope you get it. Nah, lainnya misalnya ini skripsinya. Skripsinya ini siapa? Mbak Astrita, ya, Mbak Astrita tesis about euphemism, ya, itu sama commendatory and derogatory, ya. Colorful meaning di sini maksudnya apa? Jadi makna itu kadang secara sense ada tambahannya, secara feeling tadi, ya, ke yang memperhalus atau memperkasar. Itu kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia juga ada, ya. Derogasi dan euphemism. Nah, euphemism kalau dalam bahasa Inggris. Tough-minded. Ruthless dan sebagainya. Teman-teman, you can read it ya, yeah, or rewatch the video ya, yeah, one by one. Nah, ini sudut pandangnya tergantung feeling seseorang ya. Misalnya si A dan si B itu dipandang oleh si C. Si C bilang suka sama si A. Dia itu dibilangnya oh childlike. Ya, itu pemilihan kata mempengaruhi. Lalu karena enggak suka sama si B, ih childish. Sifat yang seperti anak-anak, kalau dibilang si B karena enggak suka, pemilihan katanya childish. Kalau ke yang A karena dia pro, suka temannya dan lain-lain, dia childlike. Misalnya ya, it's about body shaming, but because this is about academic setting ya, it's not about something else. Misalnya tadi slim, oh he is slim, slender. Karena dia pakai pemilihan kata yang lain, skinny. Nanti kesannya sama orang yang mendengar beda. Oh I'm skinny, oh lanky, weedy, dan sebagainya. So that difference. That's why it is about emotive meaning. Ya? Affective meaning. Yeah, the next is about reflected meaning. Yeah, from Geoffrey Lee, if arises in cases of multiple conceptual meaning. Nah, kita kalau punya multiple conceptual meaning, we can have a reflective meaning. Yeah, when one sense of a word forms part of our response to another sense, what is communicated through association with another sense with the same expression. Ya, misalnya many taboo terms are result of this. Contohnya taboo terms ya. Ini. Holy Ghost misalnya ya. Karena itu from Trinity. Kalau dalam agama saya ada Tritunggal Maha Kudus. Nah, itu ini western ya, western culture in the court service itu Holy Ghost from the Comforter lalu ke lainnya nanti ada namanya reflected meaning ya. One sense that form another sense. Yeah, for instance, on hearing the church service, the synonymous expression, the Comforter and the Holy Ghost both refer to the third Trinity, but the Comforter sounds warm and comforted, while the Holy Ghost sounds awesome. Nah, seperti itu. Misalnya gini, gay itu munculnya bisa reflected meaningnya ke happy, bisa ke homosexual. Intercourse, itu kan intercourse. We do an intercourse here, karena maknanya itu reflected meaning. Ya. Yeah? Communication itu intercourse, tapi bisa saja aturannya ke sexual intercourse karena ya more than one conceptual meaning itu kalau dalam bahasa simpelnya ambiguity itu bisa masuk dalam sini juga. Yang terakhir berhubungan dengan collocation ya, collocative meaning. What is collocative meaning? Collocative meaning is the association of word acquires on account of the meanings of word which tends to occur in its environment. Nah, karena adanya collocation, kolokasi itu kan pasangan-pasangannya. Ya, makna ini cenderung berpasangan dengan makna ini. Kata ini, frase ini. Seperti itu. Misalnya, pretty. Ya, not. In a very common way, ini collocative meaning ya, pretty girl, pretty boy, pretty woman. Ya, kalau handsome nanti berbeda dengan handsome boy, handsome man, handsome car. Ya itu dalam sebuah padanan kata. Then the last, tadi masih 5, maksudnya 6 terakhir itu ketujuh dalam list ya, ke-6 dalam associative meaning itu ada namanya thematic meaning ya, pembagian khusus dari associative meaning. What is communicated by the way in which a speaker or writer organize the message in terms of ordering, focus, and emphasis. Jadi, organization of the message. Susunannya. Kan bisa ordernya, fokusnya kemana, penekannya kemana, ini masuk ke thematic. Ya. Mrs. Bessie Smith donated the first prize. The first prize was donated by Mrs. Bessie Smith. Nah, satu fokusnya ke pemberinya, Mrs. Bessie Smith. Dua, ke hadiah keberapanya. Nah, itu namanya pemilihan susunan kata dan lain-lainnya. Nanti cenderung kita kaitkan ke thematic meaning. Mana yang mau jadikan highlight? Mana? Which one that is highlighted? Which one that can be a focus? It's about thematic meaning. They stopped at the end of the corridor. Nah, fokus ke mereka berhentinya ya. Mereka itu berhenti loh. Cuma tambahan keterangannya lah at the end of the corridor. Tapi lainnya, tempatnya, lokasinya, adverbnya dia jadikan fokus. At the end of the corridor, misalnya at the end of the corridor itu sesuatu yang jadi fokus ya. They stop. Okay, that's about thematic meaning ya. Ini penjelasan dari tadi. Ini summary-nya. Jadi, seven types of meaning by Geoffrey Lee. Kita ada dua pembagian, conceptual sama asosiatif. Conceptual itu logical, konotatif, or denotatif. Lalu ke asosiatif itu terbagi dari konotatif sampai tematik ya. Kalau konotatif itu what is communicate by virtue, what language differs. Dan social itu ke social circumstances. Kalau affective itu related to the feeling or attitude of the speaker through the language, reflected tadi tentang association with another sense of the same word, ya, yeah. Another sense that form one. Collocative itu ya, collocation, association with words, with ke with another words, word and words, pairing, and extra. Thematic meaning is about an order, how we organize that. That can be about emphasizes, focus, ordering, and etc. Okay. So if we got the other references, yeah, we can have another focus later on from the same approach, but have kind of modification from another expert, because we have Lee as a basic. Nanti karena semantic pragmatic from Geoffrey Leach itu basicnya, ya teman-teman bisa, you can reread or rewatch ya this kind of explanation, then try to absorb the understanding once again, because here is still one way ya, mostly one way from my presentation. And you can have a several activeness tadi with responding to kind of review, mostly about review and related with the what's that, our current explanation about seven types of meaning ya, yeah. Nanti teman-teman bisa membandingkan line approach. Nah, saya ketikkan di sini ya di chat. Pengembangannya dari seven types of meaning ya, atau ya ada pertanyaan dalam pertemuan ini?
Not yet, sir.
Okay, thank you for your response ya. Atau mungkin Palmer. Ya, ini untuk bahan bacaan ya. Tugasnya tidak ada tugas yang harus dikumpulkan untuk minggu ini. Tugasnya cuma ya, I trust you to read another reference. Jadi teman-teman bisa baca Palmer, types of meaning of Palmer, sama types of meaning of Lyon ya. Tapi itu hanya pembandingnya. Teman-teman bisa mengacu ke salah satu ahli besok kalau dalam skripsi atau apa, atau modifikasi. Nah, itu we can have a wide range of reading ya, maksudnya kita bisa memahami, oh kalau pendekatannya the approach from Lee itu seperti ini, oh kalau dalam Palmer itu ada tambahannya ini atau ini, beda sudut pandang dan sebagainya, kalau dalam Lyon itu ada seperti ini. Nanti teman-teman itu baca sebagai tambahan ya, from the meaning of meaning from Lee, seven types of meaning, ya, in comparison to Palmer's or Leon approaches. Ya, itu mana? Jadi kalau dalam Lee itu seven types of meaning, nanti dalam Palmer approach itu seperti apa pendekatannya, ya, dan lain-lain. Tidak ada? Nanti the rest of the activity, ya, beberapa menit, nanti ada penugasan individu, maksudnya itu. Jadi reading is your weekly activity, ya. Ini teman-teman saya arahkan untuk membaca Palmer's approach, lalu lainnya Leon approach. Oke. Tadi ada yang izin karena vaksin, oke. Sama recordingnya juga, anu, akhirnya low, nggak apa-apa. Tadi in my class we have flexibility sesuai prinsip linguistik kan. Descriptivism and prescriptivism. Ada rule, ada reality ya. Kita harus sebagai language learner, teacher itu harus jangan seperti pakai kacamata kuda ya. A ya A, tidak. Apalagi kita humaniora ya. Kita harus mensiasati itu, ada toleransi dan sebagainya yang logis ya. Oke. Supaya teman-teman tidak terbawa. Saya sebagai sekarang guru kalian di sini ya. Kalau teman-teman besok menjadi guru untuk anak-anak kalian, guru untuk orang-orang lain, bisa humanis ya, jangan ya very strict with the rule sampai meninggalkan apa itu esensi dari pendidikan itu sendiri ya. Ya. Ya, ini hanya intermezzo tapi sangat penting karena untuk approach teman-teman nanti lainnya towards other, whether in daily conversation, in teaching and learning process or in your working field later on. Tadi sudah saya presensi dua kali. Saya presensi terakhir sebagai checking ya di kelas kita. Ini ada 14. Ada Mbak Siti, ada Mbak Astri, ada Mas Bayu, Mbak Desmike, Mbak Devi, Mbak Dila, Mbak Erviana, Mbak Hilda, Mbak Hana, Mas Ilmi, Mas Rizal, Mbak Syahada, and Mas Yusuf. Oke. Itu. Oke. Oh, maaf saya tes. Saya ketik ya tadi chat-nya ke private ya. Oke. Itu ya Palmer approach ya, Palmer and Jan's approach. Oke, kalau tidak ada pertanyaan dan sudah saya berikan tugas individu untuk membaca ya, reading di waktu luangnya bebas. Jadi kelas saya sangat fleksibel off cam, sementara enggak apa-apa karena teori-teori besok kalau misalnya kita praktek ya bisa on cam. Untuk lain-lainnya nanti kita diskusikan di minggu depan ya. Terima kasih kedatangannya. Thank you very much for your attending. Ya, goodbye and see you again the next week. Ya, saya umumkan besok synchronous atau asynchronous.